Hey everyone, my name is Riley, and today I'm going to teach you how to manufacture fake outrage, get a lot of clicks, make a lot of money, and unnecessarily demonize an entire community. The first step you're going to want to take is find a community that's incredibly easy to scapegoat. The best catch-all option for this is just generic feminists or SJWs, but you can also get more specific and go with trans people or gay people. Once you've identified your target community, you're going to want to invent something for them to do. Be careful though, because it shouldn't be something they would actually do or want, because that wouldn't get people mad enough. No, you want to make up something that's an exaggerated caricature of that community. For example, do you think feminists are on a diabolical rampage to turn Santa gender neutral? Of course not, that's ridiculous, but the internet doesn't know that. So just tell everyone that the evil SJWs want to make Santa gender neutral. That will infuriate everyone and make them hate those awful feminists, but it will get lots of people to click on and share your article about it, which means publicity, engagement, and ad revenue for you. And who cares about the people you're demonizing? Those people aren't you, and therefore you don't have to care about them. Because as we all know, compassion is vastly overrated. But what's that, you say? No one's going to believe you if your source is just some random SJW said this? Well then, it's time that I taught you how to manipulate a survey for your benefit. Sticking with the gender neutral Santa example, you could send out a survey to a bunch of people that looks like this. The questions could ask stuff like, if you could rebrand Santa for modern society, what gender would he be? And how would you modernize Santa's transport? Because to the person taking the survey, that all sounds like it's in good fun. It's hypothetical. They're being asked on some weird internet survey how they could modernize Santa. Why not say that he could be gender neutral or female or ride a hoverboard or drink beer or have an iPhone? That stuff is fun, and after all, this survey is just asking these questions for fun, right? And that's how you get them. Then only report on their answers that pertain to gender, ignore all the hoverboard and beer and iPhone answers because that would only complicate things. And then instead of saying that some bored people on the internet thought maybe this is how they could modernize Santa if they had to, say that 1 in 4 people think Santa should be female or gender neutral. And that word should is important because it was not in the original question. If you had asked people something more accurate, like should all depictions of Santa be gender neutral or female, or do you think we should force all depictions of Santa to be gender neutral or female, you would get some different answers. And those answers wouldn't be very useful for getting rage clicks. So there you go, that's how you make your claim sound sciencey because you had a survey, even though it's all complete bullshit. But you might be asking, what if you don't want to go through all the trouble of making an online survey? Well, no worries, because if you just go on Fox News, you don't even need the facade of having evidence. For this example, let's talk about gingerbread men, or as the evil SJWs want us to call them, gingerbread people. For this plan, you're only going to need one little molehill, and then I'm going to help you make a mountain out of it. In this case, our molehill is that the cafe and the Scottish Parliament decided to call some of their cookies gingerbread people instead of gingerbread men. Now, obviously, this isn't a big deal. It's just a cookie in a single cafe in Scotland. But with that kind of attitude, you'll never get any rage clicks. And if you're on Fox News and advertisers are boycotting your white supremacist show, you really need some rage clicks. So it's time to make that molehill into a mountain. Pretend that you really believe that cookies have a gender and that you really care about that cookie's gender. And then pretend that this one cafe calling them gingerbread people is going to have some kind of ripple effect that results in governments banning private citizens from ever saying the words gingerbread man. See, now you have yourself a scary, rage-inducing story. Those damn feminists are trying to de-genderify your cookies. How could you let that happen? And then, people watching your show get mad at all those awful feminists, even though you and I know they didn't actually do anything, and, in fact, they really don't care what you call your fucking cookies. But then you get the rage views, you get the rage ad money, and everything is fine. No one will think it's weird at all that you're so obsessed with the gender of cookies. And for one final example, let's talk about what you'd do if you wanted to target trans and gay people specifically, not just feminists. In that case, I have the perfect story for you that you can easily blow out of proportion with just a slight little twist, even if you proclaim to be a gay news source. So in this case, here's a story about how Switzerland recently updated their hate crime laws. Previously, their laws stated that if a crime was committed against someone because of the victim's race, ethnicity, or religion, then that crime would be considered a hate crime and more harshly punished. However, recently, Switzerland updated that hate crime definition to include sexual orientation and gender identity. This seems like a pretty standard thing. The US has had a federal hate crime law in place since 1969, and in 2009, they updated it to include sexual orientation and gender identity. Laws like this are not uncommon, because as a society, we have generally decided that hate crimes are bad. But all of that is boring and won't get anyone angry. If you want ad revenue, you gotta get people angry over nothing. So instead of boring people to death with the details of hate crime laws, just say, Switzerland votes to send people to prison for homophobia and transphobia. Or, Switzerland rules transphobia and homophobia illegal. Because that will get people riled up. What exactly does transphobia or homophobia mean? Will people spend years in jail because they accidentally misgendered someone? Will straight people get the death penalty for laughing at a bad gay joke? Of course not, but the people on the internet don't know that, and they're not gonna bother to take the time to research it before getting mad, so they'll share your article all over the place and direct their anger at innocent queer people. But you profit, so it's okay. Anyway, that's all you need to know for scamming the internet, making people mad, harming innocent communities, and making some money off of it all. I hope this can help you go out there and be as unnecessarily cruel as you've always wanted. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Okay, hi, Sarcastic Riley is gone. It's just me now, Normal Riley. Just want to say here that in case it wasn't super obvious, that whole video was extremely sarcastic. I'm just really tired of all this fake outrage over things that are literally non-issues. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video and would like to see more like it, I could really use your support over on Patreon. You can click over here to check out my Patreon, which would help me out so much, or you can click up here to subscribe to this channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.